The patient called me and decided that she wanted to start the weekly bisphosphonate. I reviewed the results of the laboratory studies with her that showed she had a normal calcium, vitamin D, and kidney function. She said that she was exercising, she'd added a little bit of calcium supplement, and so I said what I wanted to do then was see her in another year. I sent her a bone density request to make certain that that would be performed prior to our visit, so then it would have been 2 years since her last bone density study. I encourage her to continue to take her calcium supplement with vitamin D and her exercise, and we'll schedule her for the appointment 1 year. Hi, Jenny. It's so good to see you back again.
And you.
How are you doing?
Fine. I've been eating well and exercising well and taking my medication.
Any medication side effects? Stomach upset, aching all over?
Well, I've had a few minor aches and pains, but I don't think anything that could be blamed on the medication.
All right. What about, are you taking it regularly?
I am, mainly, yes.
Okay. And you're taking it with that full glass of water, half hour before breakfast, on an empty stomach?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Good. And have you missed any doses or?
I was going to say, I missed a dose about 2 weeks ago. I was away on business and I missed it.
And that's perfectly fine. The study shows that as long as you take it 90% of the time, that the medicine works pretty well. So you're certainly much better than that. So you should be
congratulated.
It's hard to do. So that's really very good that you're taking it so faithfully. What about your diet? Are you eating those calcium-rich foods we talked about?
Trying. I'm eating Greek yogurt daily. And the orange juice fortified with calcium.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm always a salad, and I'm taking a calcium supplement with the vitamin D almost every day.
That's wonderful. So that's really good. What about exercise?
Well, I've been really busy recently, mm-hmm. so I've been a bit lax on it, not so regular. However, I've bought myself, because I haven't been walking as much, I bought myself a pedometer.
Wow, good.
So that I can measure my steps at work.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm measuring 5,000 steps, about 5,000 steps a day.
Isn't that amazing just in your regular daily
activities
that's, that you can
just
get
at work,
much.
Yes.
That's wonderful. So in the big picture of things, we ideally it would be 10,000 steps, so twice what
Ooh.
You're doing. But you know, you're doing so much better than you were doing 2 years ago, then I'm very happy with that. So if you have time on the weekends or when the days are longer during the week to take that 20-minute walk we talked about last time, that's going to give you even more steps. And that, again, is going to help with your bone density a little bit, but the main thing is your balance. What about that? Have you had any falls?
There were two occasions when I stopped myself falling, lost my balance, but didn't fall. And I do think the balance class that I've been going to has been really helpful.
That's great that you're doing that. So again, many good things. You're getting your diet, you're taking the calcium, you're walking and have the pedometer, and you went to the balance class. So you should feel really good about yourself, that you're really making bone health a priority. What about mm-hmm. anybody in your family with a fracture?
Yes, my sister fell and she broke her wrist.
Mm.
Yes, just like I did.
Did you have any advice for her?
Well, she wasn't going to tell her doctor because she'd been treated at the hospital, and just as I did, she thought, well, when you fall and you break a bone, it's not that abnormal. But after I'd seen you, I said to her, I think you should tell your regular doctor and, you know, maybe get a bone density test.
Very good. And you know, like you did before, lots of people think it's normal when you fall and have
yes,
that fracture.
Yes.
But that was very good because osteoporosis can tend to run in families. And so since
yes.
you have it, that's important that she be evaluated as well.
Mm-hmm.
Very good. Have you started any new medicine?
Yes, one for my blood pressure. Hydra. It's it's got a long name.
Hydrochlorothiazide?
Yes, I think that's it.
Good.
And yes, yes.
Good. And that's actually a good medicine for your bones because it's been shown that it actually reduces the amount of calcium that you urinate out, that you hold on to that. The reason I asked is because if you'd started something like the prednisone that we talked about 2 years ago, that's bad for your bones. Mm. So the hydrochlorothiazide is actually a good medicine for your bones. So two things, help your bone density and help your blood pressure. So that's really very, very good. So this is all really, really, really good news. Now, what about the bone density? I got those results, and I wanted to go over that with you today. And I see you had them done at the same facility where you had them done before.
I did.
That's really important because the difference between types of manufacturers can give us very different results, and it's hard to compare them. So I'm glad that you went to the same facility.
Yes, well, I get a mammogram done there, so I'll do them both at the same time.
That's great. So that makes it easy for you to remember and to make certain that it's done on the same type of machine. So in reviewing the results, it looks like your spine bone density went up a little bit. What it also looks like, though, is that on the picture that we get with the bone density, that you might have some arthritis in your spine that I didn't see 2 years ago. Oh. Are you having any back pain?
No, I get stiff sometimes when I've been working in the garden, but nothing that requires any medication, pain medication.
The reason I ask is because it's normal to see in your age group the osteoarthritis there in the spine, and it can actually, the machine that does the bone density can't tell the difference between bone density improving and actually the bone spurs from the osteoarthritis. So I've got some new material that I can give you compared to 2 years ago that we'll talk about, again, bending and lifting and trying to protect your back, both from developing back pain and having those compression of the spine, those spine fractures as we talked about before. So when we're done, I'll give that to you. One of the things that we also look for on that is whether you've actually had a spine fracture. And in looking at that front view on the bone density, I didn't see any evidence of a spine fracture. So that's also very good news.
Yes.
And your height is the same as it was the last time you had a bone density. Now, if you had lost height, then what we would have done is actually ordered you, after you had your bone density done, to flip over on your side, and we would have gotten a scan, a look, to see if you actually have any new fractures there in your spine, but you didn't have that. Mm. If the place where you went for the bone density didn't have that capability, we could have just ordered a lateral x-ray of the spine.
Oh.
But we didn't need to do that. So if you lost height, that would have been something that your gynecologist would have ordered in addition to the regular bone density.
Right.
So important, again, important for us to look at to make certain, because if you lost height and had a fracture, a new one, that would indicate to me that the medicine you were on might not have been working. So that's important. Or if you had the sudden onset of back pain, that could have been a new spine fracture as well. But remember what we talked about 2 years ago is that 70% of those spine breaks, those broken bones in the spine, are actually asymptomatic. So that's why every year it's important for your gynecologist to measure your height to make certain that you're not losing height. And if you are, to get one of those x-rays of the spine.
I had no idea, a reason you could lose height in as you aged was due to these spinal fractures.
And most people don't, but that's why some of the bone density machines now have this, but why it's the recommendation every year to get that height measurement to make sure you haven't lost it, as long as you know what your peak height was. And most women tend to remember that because we want to be as tall as we were before. Your hip measurement.
Yes. What is my hip measurement?
Now, if we look at that, what we see is that the left hip bone density went up 2%.
Yes.
And the right hip bone density went up 1%.
Oh.
So these are good.
Yes.
They're not a significant amount. But what the data suggests is that even if the bone density had stayed the same, that the bones are getting stronger. So that means that the medicine that you're taking is actually working.
This is good news.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So what, I mean, I'm taking the medication and I'm not getting side effects. Seems to be working. So what's the next step?
Well, if your bone density hadn't improved like it did, what we would talk about was changing. Well, first I talked to make sure you were really telling me the truth and taking the medicine like you're supposed to.
Yes.
And that you were taking it, you know, that 90% of the time. Like.
Yes, what would have happened if it had decreased rather than...
If it had gone down and you'd done all those things and your vitamin D level was normal and you were taking your calcium, then I would have talked to you probably about changing to a medicine that wasn't taken by mouth, because I would be assuming that you probably weren't absorbing it. So then we have to revisit giving you that shot in the arm every 6 months or getting that intravenous infusion once a year. But luckily, it looks like your body is responding. But those are things that we would have talked about and something we might talk about in the future if your bone density does tend to go down. So what we'll do now is...
Yes, what's the next step?
I'll give you a slip to have the bone density repeated in 2 or 3 years, again at the same facility.
Mm-hmm.
I'll give you a slip to have that calcium, vitamin D, and kidney function checked again, and I can let you know what those, you know, results look like. I want you to continue trying to get up to that 10,000 steps if you can. Keep taking that calcium supplement like you are. And then I want you to let me know if you have any medicine side effects, or certainly if you break any bones, because then that would suggest that maybe the medicine wasn't working as well as we wanted it to.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Pleasure seeing you again, and I'll send a copy of our visit today to your gynecologist. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr.
You're welcome.